Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika on Facebook Live. Joining me today for our Talanoa is the Minister for Pacific Peoples and National Candidate for Te Atatū, Alfred Ngaro, and Nationals Candidate for Mangere, Agnes Loheni. Tanofa lover, and welcome to you both. Agnes, yeah, Marolele, Tongan Language Week, that's right. Agnes, I want to start with you. You've thrown your hat in the ring for National. Why is that?
Well, when I look back on my life and the achievements that I've led in my life around, you know, I'm a businesswoman, Mena is one of the most well-known Pacific brands. I'm a mother of five, I'm a qualified chemical engineer. I look back on those achievements, but I also look back on the trials and the tribulations, and I look a bit on the way that we have been, as a family, really resilient in ensuring that we just do the best we can for ourselves and we work really hard. And ultimately, those values align really well with the National Party.
Have you always voted National? Have you always supported the party?
I've supported the party for about the last 5 or 6 years. I did vote National for the last two elections. And, you know, as a Pacific woman, as a Samoan woman, most, you know, our parents generally have come from being Labor supporters. And I understand that. But I also understand now, as I've said, during the experiences that I've had in my life, that because my parents had such a focus on education, and that they knew when they came here from Samoa, that education was the key to the opportunities here for us, that I wanted to be part of this party because I believe this party delivers on that.
Alfred, I want to talk to you about representation in the party just quickly, because I'm looking at Agnes, and she's quite a rare breed, isn't she, in the National Party? Successful businesswoman, Samoan, and a female. Well, what's your take on that in terms of trying to get more Pacific people into the National Party?
I think that sends a really clear message that the landscape of choice for our Pacifica people has changed. As Agnes said, when we first came through here to New Zealand, when we migrated, many of our Pacifica people chose Labor as the way forward. That's changed. Yeah. And we've seen that change many times over, right across the whole of political landscape. And I think we've had others than the Pacifica, Pisita, who came through as well, and myself, and then now we've got Agnes. And to me, that's just a growing, I suppose, confidence that people have in the National-led government.
I want to talk about, excuse me, the landscape changing, because the recent poll this week about the Colmar-Brunton polls, seeing National support slowly dropping. Are you worried at all and seeing the rise of Labor?
No, I put it down as the 9-year itch. So what happens is that people said if they've been in the car for 9 years, they think, like, this car's been faithful, it's been loyal. Actually, it's taken us to a lot of places. Through some tough times, it's been able to deliver us to places that we wanted to go. So people are now saying, is it time for change? So I think then when people sort of consider that, what is it they want to look forward to actually moving on into the future, and even for Pacifica, my message to them is that, yes, we should change, maybe we should upgrade, but stick with the same brand, because that brand has been loyal and faithful, and it's achieved many things for Pacific.
Is it like an old school Toyota Corolla? Yeah. Are people thinking they want to upgrade to the new
brand? We need to be careful, because, you know, I can't actually, and none of us can actually, you know, promote one brand. But I would say in this case, if we think about the analogy about the National-led government, it's a government that has proved many times and has delivered for Pacifica in many ways. So Neil, I'll give you a good example. When I was down at the Pacifica Futures Whānau Water Commissioning Agent Conference, and one of the Pacific leaders, you know, stood up and said, you know, Alfred, we don't need other people to save us. You know, we can save ourselves. And all we need and all we ask for is the same opportunities as anyone else.
And that's, I guess, the whole idea behind your view as a National Party member, isn't it? That you're thinking Pacific people should solve their own problems. We don't need as much social investment splashing the cash around. Is that your kind of thinking around that in terms of the problems our Pacific people face?
Yeah, look, it's the thing that one of our values that we don't need people to do things for us. We need to do things with them, and that's the National Party's way. So, for instance, if you think about education, what we've seen in 2008, when they measured the level of educational achievement for Pacifica in NCA Level 2, it was around about 51%. Mm-hmm. Now, what the National-led government has come in has actually said, actually, we want to set a target for achievement. Education is important. In 2016, that level was now at 82%. That's near the national average. That's the achievement that we've begun to see under a National-led government. We were not afraid to ask the right questions to actually say that we're in set a target for achievement.
Agnes, I want to talk to you about the poll result, because you're sitting on, I think, 46. Are you on the list?
49.
So for you to get in, your party probably needs to poll around 45, 46%. It's not happening at the moment. Are you worried at all by the polls? I mean, you probably asked you maybe 8 weeks ago and you might have been a shoo-in, but are you worried now that you're seeing these poll results?
I'm not worried at all. I'm actually just focusing on getting out in front of the people in Māngere. I was at a school yesterday, Māngere College, and we had the Prime Minister with us. And one of the Tongan students there said to me, and she's been quite engaged, and she said to me, "What can you do for Māngere?" Fantastic question. And I said to her, well, I actually believe you can do a lot for yourself. And what we as a government can do is ensure that we provide an environment where there are jobs and opportunities for our young people to have, to grab onto, and to have options.
That's such a, pardon me, that's such a tough seat, isn't it, to try and win as a National Party member? Because you look at that electorate, I think the last election sort of had a 15,000 vote majority. Is it hard trying to get the cut through as a National Party member when you've got a bunch of loyal supporters there who stringently follow Labor?
There is a challenge there, but the other challenge in Māngere is actually engagement and voting. Mm. Still, a lot of our people aren't actually getting out to vote, regardless of whether it's Labor or any other parties. So to me, it's around ensuring that we have a message and an aspirational message for the young people that connects with them. It connects with what they want to get out of their lives. So getting out and knocking on, I've literally knocked on hundreds of doors, and I'm talking to families and asking them what's important to them. What they're saying to me is just general well-being of their families, you know, health, education, and employment. Those are really the big key things that I'm hearing back.
Yeah. Is it frustrating sometimes when you're going there and you talk to people and you realise that they just won't change their mind, they won't change their view if they're loyal to the Labor Party, but you still sort of truck on and try and get those key messages across from your party?
You can't give up. You just got to keep going. And I think that's incumbent on us as servants, and we're here as public servants, that is our role, that we don't give up on anybody.
Alfred, what's the plan of attack from here on in? I mean, how's your seat in Te Aratū looking against Phil Twyford?
Yeah, so I mean, part of the values of the National Party is to work hard, to work smart. And look, Te Aratū, West Auckland, where I was raised, educated, trained, got married, raised my kids. Over there, that pioneering spirit is very much part of what I have delivered and offered to Te Aratū as well.
Because you did quite well there last election. Well, I was with you on election.
Well, that's right, you were, and you spoke to my mum.
Yes, that's right. Yeah, yeah, bless her. How is she?
She's doing really well.
Yeah,
she's doing very well. Yeah. Look, the great thing about in the 2 months that I went in 2014, I halved the majority that was there. And part of it is because people know that I've actually come back, I was raised there as well. But the other part is that in that 2.5 years that I've been there, I've been working hard in the schools, in the community with businesses, addressing some of the critical issues of concern that have been raised as well. So for us, it's not just about what's happening up here in the media and other places like that. Actually, it's the ground game. It's being on the ground, being in the places that people can meet, talk to you, and talk about the things that, number one, not just what they're concerned about, but they would like you also to champion, you know, some of their aspirations that are out there in our community. And look, that's the same thing too. I'd have to say that the reasons why I think that Bill English, you know, is a great Prime Minister and will continue to be a great Prime Minister for us, because his family is our family, Bill and Mary English. So his children are half Samoan as well, with a bit of Italian mix inside of there. But so he knows what it means to come from large families, Pasifika families, actually the aspirations that they have. And what I was sort of struck by, and I've had other people talk to me about, when he was asked by Paddy Garrow about, what is your point of difference? And he said, I got up. He got up when he faced his darkest days, when he knew the challenge was before him, he got up and he kept going.
That's probably the most passion I've seen Bill when he gave that answer on that debate, isn't it?
Well, that's right. And, you know, he's a southern man, so they're small on talk but big on action. And that's what he's been able to prove. And if anyone's going to say then, so what's the point of difference that we have as a government, as a national-led government, it's about we're big on action. You just need to look across the results that we have, that we've been able to achieve, not only in education. You take, for instance, whānau order, what about Pacific Commissioning Agents? For the first time, our people get to choose how they distribute that cash to our own providers to do it our way. And you know, so nearly that's the point of difference. Mm. We're not doing it for people, we're doing it with our communities.
Mm. Agnes, I want to ask you about what your view is on the biggest issue you think that's facing our Pacific people of this generation. What do you think it is? Is it housing, poverty? Is it the aspirational dream? What do you think it is that's the next 10 years that our Pacific people look back on and think, you know, the biggest obstacle we faced was this?
As I said, when I've been door knocking, the biggest, the most feedback that I'm getting back from those that, you know, want to have a chat with me is that they think about their children. They want opportunities and pathways for their children, health. And then I remind them, well, actually now, under National League Government, children under 13 get to go, you can take them to your GP for free. That just takes a huge burden out of that part of for their families. And also around, they want some assurances around employment. And those, we can provide that because we've delivered a really strong economy. And off the back of that economy, we've grown, there's 180,000 new jobs in the last 18 months. And that's not government creating jobs, that's government backing people, businesses like mine, to be confident to want to grow their businesses.
Yeah, I want to talk to you a bit about business, because you know a thing or two about it, you're running your own. But in Ministry of Business Innovation Employment, they said in 2012 that the number of Pacific people running their own businesses is really small. I think it was about 1.6% of people, small to medium businesses. I just want to know, why do you think that is? Why aren't more Pacific people, do you think, getting involved in businesses? Because it seems to me Pacific people hire Pacific people, and yet we don't have Pacific people who are running their own businesses. Why do you think that is?
I mean, that's an area that I've been really passionate about. As I've been in business, I've been asked to speak and to mentor emerging business owners or startups. And one of the things is we're big on ideas, we're really creative, very innovative, and it's around just wanting some support to around the operational side, around...
It's all quite foreign, eh? I mean, it's specific moment coming out. I guess, you know, when we come from the islands, we get the business idea. You know, you make something, you sell it, you make a profit. And you come to New Zealand, you got the GST and tax and all this. I mean, is it just trying to support them? Is that what you want to do, is being from the background that you have in business?
And the other thing is, it's actually, I mean, there's the fallacy around that, you know, National is only about corporate business. It's actually not. The backbone of our economy is actually small and medium-sized businesses, your mum and dad businesses. And we do want to ensure that the cost of doing business for them is less. It's easier just cutting out the red tape, and so they can focus on doing the things that they're really good at, which is being innovative and growing and being competitive.
Mm-hmm. I think to add to what Agnes is saying is that, so we came in the 50s and 60s to fill a labour shortage that was currently here in New Zealand post-World War II. Mm-hmm. So we're still, in a sense, what I think is working for people rather than working for ourselves. And the National League Government has actually been very clear around setting some targets and goals to grow, you know, the opportunities, Pacific Business Trust, for instance. And it's not just about capital and seed funding. So you have to change the mindset right from the start. If you think about our young enterprise schemes that we've got now, and we're developing and growing that, number of young Pacific are now coming through. In fact, the last 2 years we've had Pacifica feature either right at the top or actually winning those awards with young and youth enterprise. The other part of it is that this week we were talking about, and next week there's going to be the launch of some of these programs that Pacific Business Trust will be encouraging more of our Pacifica young people to enter into the opportunities to innovate and go into businesses. So our role as a government is to encourage that pipeline and that pathway. Scholarships such as for STEM subjects, mm-hmm. science, technology, the Te Aloha scholarships. We had 25 of these. But, you know, so nearly one of the biggest challenges that we have is to tell our story. And sometimes we don't have everyone that wants to hear our story. In fact, it's easier to turn around and look at all the things when they go wrong rather than the things that go right. And I believe the fact is that we've had a disservice when we've not had enough focus on saying, here are some wonderful things that our Pacifica people are doing. A good example, for instance, tonight we've got the Poor Fear Fear, where we're going to be celebrating and acknowledging Pacific success in business and community and sports. You know, for the first time, we're now going to have our first Dame and Knight, Dame Valerie Adams and Sir Michael Jones. And we've tonight, over the last 3 years, we're going to celebrate at least 40 of our Pacifica who have been honoured for their roles and for what they've contributed.
I want to go in there because I'm getting someone's in my ear, but just quickly before we go, I just want 15 seconds each on why it's a two-horse race, Labour, National. Why should Pacific people go National over Labour?
Frankly, because we can deliver. We can deliver a strong economy that's going to support our young people into jobs, that's going to support the people that need it to get up as well.
What's your vision, Alfred? Well, succinct manner.
Well, our succinct and our vision is simply this. Like our families who work hard and work smart, provide an income to be able to do the things that matter most, We're a government that actually provides an income through an economy that can pay for the things that we think are important: health, education, employment. And we're aspirational. We're not prepared to leave our people in places that they shouldn't be, and we're going to promote all the great things that we do.
Cool. All right. Thank you so much for joining us on the show. Could keep going on and on, but I'll get in trouble, so I better wrap it up there. That's the National Party for you. Te atu to candidate Minister of Pacific Peoples Alfred Ngaro and also Agnes Loheni, candidate for Mangere. Thanks again for joining us on another Election Talanoa. We'll be back next week with another segment for this show. Until then, tō whāsoi fua, ma manawi leve aso.